Hello everyone, this is Gaurav Hara from IIIT Kota, second year EC department, and my project partner is Dhruv Kumar Singhal. And here we are with our major Python project. We have created a live finger detector which will count how many fingers we have lifted up. So in this project we have used two main modules, two main libraries, CV2 and MediaPipe. CV2 is just foundation which is used to take input. The main library is MediaPipe. MediaPipe is built and maintained by Google. MediaPipe consists of multiple modules which will work together. MediaPipe will mark landmark on our hand. When we show our hand, it will mark landmark. And like this, MediaPipe will mark 1, 2, 3. If 1 is less than 3, then it will count finger is closed. And if 1 is greater than 3, it will count finger is up. So basically, we have used this concept and make our Python project. Now, Dhruv Kumar Singhal will explain the further code and give you more information about our project. Thank you.
So as Gaurav talked to you through our project, the library we used, the things we did, like using the while loop and etc., etc. Now let me walk through our code and explain line by line how did we did the our project. So first of all, we imported the libraries, the OpenCV library and the MediaPipe library. We named MediaPipe library as MP to use it more efficiently. Then first we capture our video using the capture variable CAP and the OpenCV. Using the OpenCV library, we use cv2.videocapture that will capture our webcam. And next, we use the hand solution. And this will give us the context of our hand, the physical significance of our hand context it will give. Next is we use mphands.hands so that it can define the hands, like this is a hand. The MediaPipe will define this is hand. And for the solution, it will define on the hands what is a context it will give for the hands. As for the computer, it will automatically do the context thing and the stuff. But for us normal human beings, we need to see what's going on here. What is the point it is getting, how it's up or down or how it is. So we will draw the utils on it so that we can see what's going on here. So we will use the MediaPipe drawer library and use the drawing utils. And next, these are the coordinates we defined. Well, these coordinates are already defined by MediaPipes. They are like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16, and 20. So these are the context. These are the coordinates defined by. Why are we using them? Well, when 8 is less than 6, like 8 is below 6, then this finger is down. When it is above 6, 8 is above 6, this finger is up. So that's how we will know. Well, we will talk about it later stages. Let's first go to the other code. This we will explain it later. And we defined thumb differently because of some reasons. I will define it later. So we defined the MP draw function to draw this. Now we will use that. Let's see if capturing is true, like if capturing is success. So what we'll get, that we will get two things. We will get the success and we will get the image cap read. Image cap read function is get us the frame, a single frame wise from the video capture. Like it will process the single frame for us. So it will get one frame, then another frame, then another frame, and that's all. But now comes the image RGB convert. Well, why are we converting the normal blue, green, red format to RGB? Well, it's the compulsion of the MediaPipe library that it needs the image or the video in the RGB format. So we will use the convert color image to color VGR to RGB. Now, what we'll get, now next thing we get from cap.read, we will get the images. Now we have converted that image into RGB file. Now MediaPipe can be applicable. So what we'll get, we will use these hands. We have the hands I explained you about the hands, like it will give us the hands. So it will process our hands from these RGB images. So our hands will be processed here. Then what will it do? It will, on this result, we will get the multi-land hand marks. We will, what we will get? We will give multi-hand landmarks on it so that we can see what is going on in it. So we'll get multi-hand landmarks like that I explained, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 12. So next is we use make if multi landmarks. Well, why do you use it? Well, if I'm showing my hand in camera, then there is hand, but if I am not, there is no hand. So if we use if function to define, like if hand is there, so that's why we use the hand points array. Well, I will define it later why we use the array hand points. Well, it will use to store the coordinates of our points. I'll explain it. So for hand LMS in multi landmarks, so we'll hand LMS on dono hands, we use both hands in multi landmarks. We used MP draw landmarks. We will use the drawings of the image hand LMS MP hand connection. The points we are have, we will make them connections so that it will be like a net of our structure, so that we can define it more properly, like a hand. Like points moving around will be very weird, so we use the hand connection in our hand. So we use hand LMS so that one hand, two hand, or whatever. So next we have for IDX. For IDX LM in enumerate. Well, that now we got hand. First we got the image. Let me show. We got the image from here. We converted it into the RGB. Now next we get the hands to process. From that we use the multi-land hand marks. That those multi-land marks we will use to make the connections. Now what we'll do? We will do the iteration on these hand marks. What we will do? We will, as if like when we use this programming, these points in camera in this window, it shows the coordinates in real life, like 0.867, blah blah 8. So we need to show it moving. We need to show it moving. So we need pixels. We need pixels to define this. Why? Because like coordinates are moving. If I move my hand, then also coordinates are moving. So that brings confusion. So we will use pixels to define it. So what we'll do? First, we will get the height, width, and color scheme of the image. So height, width, and color scheme of the. Next, we will define the pixels in Intel. What we did, we multiplied the x coordinate of our pixel with width. So x coordinate with width, that will give the pixel width, and the height, the y coordinate into height. So it will give us the pixel height. So pixel width, pixel height. So we will get a complete pixel, like a width and a height. So we get a pixel. Now what we get? We get the hand points dot append cx dot cy. We get we append them. Now the important part. So now we have the hand points. Well, we can also customize these. So if you want to, we will do the OpenCV library cv2.circle image point, and then we will customize its size and its color and see if it's filled or not. So that's very easy. It's just customizing the dots, nothing else. Next we put the up count zero. We did so that we say that no finger is opened. Okay, so all fingers are closed. So for coordinate in the finger coordinate, we use the coordinate command in finger coordinates. What we will do, if hand points coordinate 01 greater than hand points 11, then up count is a plus 1. So what we did is, like, these are our points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So what we will do, if this point of finger 8 is below 6, then the finger is closed. If this point is above 6, finger is open. So what we get, if this 8 is greater than 6, then finger is open. If it 8 is less than 6, finger is closed. And on which axis we are comparing? The y-axis. As you can see, y-axis, we can see. So what we did, we use the if command, if this is, and put the hand points coordinate 0, the hand points coordinate we defined earlier, the finger coordinates 8, 6, 12, 18, 12, 10, 16, 14, 20, 18. So 0, like 8, 0 will define the 8, the 1 will define the 6. So 8, 6. And just a second. So in this, when coordinate 0, 1, and on which axis? Y-axis. As you can see, 1, y-axis. On y-axis, we are comparing both hand points. And if it is greater, if 8 is greater, we are putting the count plus 1. Means one finger is open, and we are providing the for loop, so it will go for one finger, two finger, three finger, four, all the fingers, which have coordinates like 8, 6, 12, 10, 16, 14, 20, 18. Okay, so that's the stuff. And but the concept in thumb is a totally different concept. Like this is our thumb. It doesn't go down this way. Our thumb doesn't go down this way. So it doesn't move on y axis. Instead, it moves like this. Fold. It folds. So it rather moves on x axis. So what we will do? We will check its x coordinate rather than its y coordinate. Like if thumb is here, if thumb is here, then the x coordinate is less, then the thumb is closed. If x coordinate is there, the x is greater, then the thumb is open. So that's how we will get the thumb, right? So if thumb is there, then up count is plus 1. Thumb is not there, up count is 0. No up count, that means. Okay. Now, next thing is, we will have to put the text. We have to put the text on it. Like we have to know that 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, whatever fingers are, it will show the 4, 5. But I'm just saying, like one finger, two finger, three finger. So we have to put text. So what we'll do is image up count ko string banayenge, aur uski time, uski coordinates denge, counts, jo file hogi, hamari window aayegi, uspe kahan pe wo show hoga. These are the coordinates 150, 150, x, y, and this is the font, this is the size, this is the color, and this is the width. Okay, now last is, we use the cv2.im show. This shows the image that is produced by the OpenCV. Okay, and cv2 wait key, it reloads the frames. In 1 millisecond, it will reload the frame that was read by cap.read. Cap.read reads our images, na? These process our images. So it will reload the frames, and that's how in 1 millisecond, we are getting different outputs. So different frames, and these frames are reloading. So at last I will show you the code, and for that I have to I have to turn off my video because it doesn't work that way. 4, 2, 1, 0. Okay, we are moving it in the x position, so it is going like that. 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 2. Okay, so that's how we did this. So thank you. That was our project, and we wish you enjoyed our project. Thank you.